Welcome to Declassify Malaysia. In Chapter 14, we will discuss the status of Jawi in Sarawak. First, let us look into the arising issue. The issue is the Ministry of Education Malaysia has decided as policy to first implement Jawi writing in the Malay language subject, Bahasa Melayu subject, for Standard 4 student in the year 2020, followed with Standard 5 student in the year 2021, and Standard 6 student in the year 2022 at the National Type School, on the condition that such implementation must be agreed by PTA, Parent Teacher Association, parents and student of the school. Second, Ministry of Education Malaysia also have decided as policy to implement Jawi writing in the Malay language subject, Bahasa Melayu subject, for Standard 4 student in the year 2020, followed by Standard 5 student in the year 2021, and a Standard 6 student in the year 2022 at the national school. So, this is the federal education policy that has been agreed by the Ministry of Education, agreed by federal cabinet, and agreed by Prime Minister. Pakatan Harapan led federal government has agreed to implement this policy where Jawi writing or Jawi script will be incorporated gradually into Standard 4, Standard 5 and Standard 6 by the year 2020 up to 2022. To understand the issue at hand regarding the implementation of Jawi writing as a policy of the Ministry of Education, we need to seek our audience with IGC report and federal constitution read together with National Language Act 1963-67, namely Act 32. This is the constitutional document governing either the implementation of Jawi writing in Malay language subject is constitutional or not. Jawi writing, Jawi script become an issue because of one thing, among other things, is that there is a fear that Jawi will interfere with the religious freedom of the people. The reading of the federal constitution regarding this fear was written in Article 12 on the rights in respect with education. The specific reading is on Article 12, Clause 3 and Clause 4. In particular, Article 12, Clause 3. Article 12, Clause 3, read as follows. No person shall be required to receive instruction in or to take part in any ceremony or act of worship of a religion other than his own. Article 12, Clause 3 then continue. For the purpose of Clause 3, the religion of a person under the age of 18 years old shall be decided by his parent or guardian. Article 12, Clause 3 and Clause 4 means that student in any school, either national school, either national type school, mission school, or whatever, is protected from receiving any instruction in a religion other than his own, except if allowed by his parent. However, there is nothing in Article 12, Clause 3 that prohibits the learning of particular language of the script, of which also incidentally forms the script of a holy text of our religion. So, learning the script of any language is constitutional under the federal constitution. It must be remarked here, Jawi is a script to learn a Malay language. it is not to learn Islamic religion. So, the student is not receiving any instruction regarding Islamic religion by learning Jawi script. They are learning the Jawi script to learn the language, not to learn the religion. Therefore, the learning of a language is not an issue under Article 12, Clause 3 of the Federal Constitution. Learning of a script of a language is not an issue. Learning of Jawi script of a language is constitutional. No constitutional evidence that the teaching of Jawi writing would amount to a student receiving instruction in a religion other than his own. Now, if we read Article 152, Clause 1 of Federal Constitution, the national language is Malay language. The script of the Malay language shall be in such script as Parliament may by law provide. Article 152, Clause 1 expresses that the script or the writing of the Malay language will be provided by the Parliament. It is up to the federal government to decide which script to be used for the national language, which is for the Malay language. It is not up to the judge. It is not up to the minister. It is not up to any association. It is up to the Parliament. Under Article 44 of the Federal Constitution, Parliament consists of Yang di-Pertuan Agong, Dewan Negara, and Dewan Rakyat. That is Parliament. It is up to Yang di-Pertuan Agong, Dewan Negara, and Dewan Rakyat to decide which script to be used for national language, which script to be used for Malay language. Subsequently, the Parliament has provided the law for the script of the national language, which is Malay language, by passing National Language Act 1963-67, specifically Section 9 of Act 32. Of this Act 32 defined that the script of the national language of Malay language, it read that the script of the national language shall be the Rumi script, provided that this shall not prohibit the use of the Malay script, more commonly known as the Jawi script of the national language. Therefore, under Section 9 of Act 32, based on Article 152, Clause 1, the teaching of Jawi writing, like the teaching of the Rumi writing, is the method to learn the script of the Malay language, which is the national language. Under the Federal Constitution, Jawi script is constitutional. However, it must be noted, the use of Jawi script is constitutional to be used and teach in school in the state of Malaya only. According to Act 32, National Language Act 1963-67, only enforceable in the state of Malaya, in Peninsula Malaysia. In this case, Jawi script as a script of national language passed by Parliament is only applicable in the state of Malaya. Sarawak never adopted Act 32, the National Language Act 1963-67. It is not enforceable in Sarawak. If Act 32 is not enforceable in Sarawak, that means Section 9 of Act 32, of course, is not enforceable in Sarawak. Section 9 specified that Jawi script as the script of national language is not applicable to Sarawak. Now, let us explore the status of Jawi in Sarawak. As we can see, Federal Constitution is applicable throughout the Federation of Malaysia, and that includes the states of Malaya. Meanwhile, IGC report is part of federal constitution as it need to be read together as specified under Article 169C of the federal constitution itself. Well, international agreement made before Malaysia there is an agreement that was made between the state of Malaya and the state of Sarawak. Act 32, National Language Act, 1963-67, on the other hand, is passed by Parliament based on the federal constitution, Article 152, Clause 1, but only applicable in the state of Malaya. Why did Act 32 is not applicable in Sarawak? According to paragraph 30, clause 1 of IGC report, an international agreement between the state of Malaya and the state of Sarawak, the subject of language is part of the constitutional safeguards provided for the state of Sarawak. It is mentioned in paragraph 3, clause 1, that any provision relating to language for the state of Sarawak should not be amended or repealed without the consent of the state government. Therefore, the federal government must honor the international agreement, which is IGC report, expressed in paragraph 30, clause 1, that the rights on language is one of the constitutional safeguards for Sarawak. Language is the rights of Sarawak. Any amendment on language need consent from Sarawak government. It need to be passed in Sarawak Legislative Assembly before it can be enforced in Sarawak. Federal government can introduce an act of parliament, amend or repeal anything related to language, but it will not be enforced in Sarawak unless the consent through passing of a bill in Sarawak Legislative Assembly has been done. The constitutional safeguards on language for Sarawak also extend to the legislative rights on education. Under paragraph 17A of IGC report, any policy and system of administration of education in Sarawak will remain under the control of the state government. This means any policy on education introduced by Federal Ministry of Education is not necessarily applicable in Sarawak unless Sarawak agree. This also means Sarawak can use and develop our own policy on education. As we can see, even though education is within federal list, it is conditional. It is conditional upon Article 169C, where international agreement of IGC report must be honored and implement, giving the devolution of power upon the state government to develop and have our own policy on education. We can even have our own education ordinance, Sarawak Education Ordinance, to be enforced, to enforce the devolved rights in some part of education legislative rights, especially when it comes to local needs. Other leniency and flexibility to ensure that the imposition of Malay language will not disturb the local need of the people in Sarawak and to make it in a manner fair to all community in Sarawak, the knowledge of the Malay language will not be required for qualification or for any educational opportunity. In Sarawak, you don't need to pass Malay subject to get a position in matriculation or vernacular school or university. Sarawakian, please, if you know your right, actually, you don't need to pass the Malay language subject to go to any school. The Malay language in Sarawak is different from Malay language in Malaya. There is many community speaking other language that form the majority of the population in Sarawak. So it will be stupid to impose a language foreign to us as qualification for education opportunity. That's why we have paragraph 17 of IGC report. This provision has been agreed by Sarawak. It has been agreed by Malaya as well. Everybody signed this IGC agreement. The administrative mechanism to ensure that the policy and system of administration on education in Sarawak can be implemented based on the local needs. Paragraph 17A, 5, in bracket 5, was constructed on which the Director of Education in Sarawak will become the middleman, working in consultation between the federal government and state government on all things related to education. When it comes to the implementation of Jawi language, the Director of Education in Sarawak must first consult the state government, not the Sarawak minister or chief minister, who have to waste their time to meet with federal education minister. It is the job paid for the Director of Education in Sarawak to consult the state government. Just do your job. As for the people in Sarawak, you should voice your opinion on Jawi or anything related to education to the local education committee and board of education, or through the local education committee and board of education. Afterwards, this local education committee and board of education will submit the letter, memorandum or whatever, to the Director of Education in Sarawak. After that, based on these wishes of the people, it is the job of the Director of Education in Sarawak to consult the Federal Ministry of Education and state government. So, what the point of having the Director of Education in Sarawak if you don't know what is your constitutional duty to the people of Sarawak? Everything need Chief Minister and Sarawak Minister to handle. In addition, it is very clear that in case of Sarawak, under paragraph 17A, in the bracket 8, Roman 8, the agent for primary education in Sarawak is the local authority. The local authority has all the power on primary school throughout Sarawak. Local authority ordinance should be updated to extend the power to regulate the administration of primary school in Sarawak. In Sarawak, local authority is the one who have the easiest access to the local people, to the parent, association, and every strata of society. That is why local authority was given to RICS as an agent to administer the primary school in Sarawak. Sarawak is very big. We need local authority. We need to empower local authority. That is why we have paragraph 17A in the bracket act. They will become the agent of education for the state government for the primary school. As you can see, we have total control on primary school in Sarawak. It is up to the local authority to decide either the implementation of Jawi in standard 4, 5 and 6 as suggested as policy by the Federal Education Ministry can be implemented in Sarawak. To constitutionally extend the executive authority on education to Sarawak, which will allow Sarawak to have our own policy and system of administration on education, just follow Article 80, Clause 4, and Article 95C, Clause 1 of the Federal Constitution. Get the order of the Yang di-Pertuan Agong to extend the executive authority on policy and system of administration of education to Sarawak. Yes, education is under federal list, but under Article 169C, read together with paragraph 17A of IGC report and through devolution of power under Article 80, Clause 4 and Article 95C, Clause 1 in the bracket B, some part of the legislative rights on education can be devolved to the state government. In this case, the rights to have our own policy and system of administration should and can be devolved to state government. To further strengthen the case here, Read Annex A, List 2, Item number 5 of IGC report. Consideration should be given to the need to include other services of a local character to the state government. Clearly, educational policy and system of administration in Sarawak has its own unique local character that need to be taken into consideration. That's why the rights as spelled on education in paragraph 17 of IGC report must be devolved to the state government through constitutional means of Article 80, Clause 4 and Article 95C, Clause 1 in the bracket B. Again, let us derive more constitutional expression to further straighten our case. Under Article 77, residual power of legislation will fall within the state list if the matter is not enumerated in any of the lists in the 9th schedule. Script of national language, not being a matter in respect of which parliament has power to make law in the state of Sarawak under Article 77 and Article 169C, read together with IGC report Annex A, List 2, Item number 5, which spelled the condition just now. IGC report paragraph 17A in the bracket 2 and IGC report paragraph 30 clause 1 in the bracket 2. Therefore, Sarawak should have our own education policy through devolution of power by virtue of Article 80 clause 4 and Article 95C clause 1 in the bracket B and Article 169C read together with IGC report. If we read Article 150 in the bracket 6A of Federal Constitution, Parliament cannot touch Sarawak rights on language. Even emergency law also cannot touch Sarawak rights on language. Literally, nobody can touch Sarawak rights on language. It is up to Sarawak state government to have our own script for national language. Whatever related to language, either to use Iban, Lanao, Chinese script for national language, it is within the rights of Sarawak. To simplify everything, based on the constitutional discussion that we have, it is the duty of the parliament to honor and implement international agreement, which is IGC report under Article 169C that was made before Malaysia Day. IGC report was made before Malaysia Day on February 1963. Malaysia Day is on September 1963. The script of national language, either Rumi, Malay or Jawi, is applicable and constitutional in the states of Malaya under Article 152 Clause 1, read together with Act 32 of the Federal Law. Meanwhile, in Sarawak, the constitutional enforcement of Jawi script is not applicable because we have the rights on language and education that allow us to have our own policy and system of administration for education. Sarawak can have our own script for national language. It is up to the state government to decide either to use Rumi, Jawi or Malay script or Iban script or Chinese script for national language to be applicable in Sarawak. It is Sarawak rights also that Parliament must extend the legislative powers on policy and system of administration on education to Sarawak so that it can constitutionally define the extent of some part of legislative rights of Sarawak on education. Order of the Yang Dipertuan Agong shall be required to extend the power over the primary education to the local authority in Sarawak. Finally, I give you this some simple flow diagram to understand the intricate nature of constitutional and legislative rights of the federal government and Sarawak state government on language and education. Sarawak have our own Ministry of Education, Science and Technological Research. This ministry have the rights to develop and devise our own Sarawak education policy with consultation from the Sarawak Director of Education. It is up to Sarawak through Sarawak own policy of education either to adopt Jawi script to learn the Malay language as our national language, to constitutionally define the extent of legislative rights of Sarawak on language and education. It will require the Order of the Yang di-Pertuan Agong under Article 80, Clause 4, read together with Article 95C, Clause 1 in the bracket B. So, do your job as YB. We paid you for it. Follow this line of the Constitution. It is not that hard. It is written there. You just need to follow. Thank you.